Good morning. My speech will be about a work we did in Agris Sardinia to assess the feasibility of a genomic selection approach based on a female informative population in Sarda dairy sheep breed. The traditional breeding scheme of the Sarda breed is based on a pyramidal management of the population. At the top, there is the herd book, where the official recording of the selection criteria is performed. The main traits recorded in the flock book of the Sarda breed are milk yield, harden morphology, and scrapie resistance. Also, fat and protein contents are recorded, but just in primiparous use. The pedigree recording is performed by the single sire natural mating and the artificial insemination. The genetic improvement created in the flock book is transferred to the commercial population by the flow of natural mating rams. At the moment, we have low genetic improvement for the recorded traits in the Sarda breeding scheme. The main reasons are the insufficient rates of artificial insemination and single sire natural mating, which make the effective size of the selected population is lower than we expect. Moreover, we have a low accuracy of the recorded traits due to a very simplified recording scheme we apply to reduce cost of phenotyping. Moreover, we have a few recorded traits. At the moment, we don't have any record for animal health or other functional traits. And even if we start now to record this kind of traits, we will have a lack of extensive historical recording and so low heritabilities. In these conditions, the genomic selections seem to be attractive for dairy sheep. Both the selection assisted by causal or linkage disequilibrium markers, as well as the genomic selection as applied in dairy cattle, seem to be useful for dairy sheep. I remember you that genomic selection in dairy cattle is based on a large-scale recording of traits for bulls of the reference population and a wide use of elite bulls. So the question is if we can apply the traditional dairy cattle approach of genomic selection to dairy sheep. It is difficult because we have some technical issues. The first one is that we have, as I said before, less accurate progeny tests due to the low average number of daughters per sire. We have a lack of genetic connectedness, and we have also a low accuracy of the performance records. In this condition, it's difficult to find a well-structured reference population to estimate SNP's effects. Moreover, increasing the accuracy in dairy sheep is more relevant than shortening generation interval, that is the main goal in dairy cattle. We have also some economic issues. The SNP arrays have high cost, even if they are less and less. If related to the value of a single ewe. Moreover, the number of recorded traits is lower in sheep than in cattle. We have up to 27 traits, recorded traits in cattle, and just 5-6 traits in sheep. This means that the effectiveness of the genomic selection is lower in sheep. And the effective number of estimated SNP is even lower when we wait for the accuracy of the performance records. So the true question now is if we can develop a model of genomic selection specific of dairy sheep, taking into account technical and economic constraints. In Sardinia, we are experimenting an approach for genomic selection based on a female informative population raised in a nucleus flock. The idea is to detect the main bloodlines that are influential in the herd book population, to reproduce them in the female nucleus by artificial insemination or natural mating size, so generate use which carry out the chromosome segments segregating in the book population, measure this use for several traits, genotype them with the 50K Illumina bait chip, detect influential animals to be sequenced by the next generation sequence method for imputing genotypes to the whole population, and also perform a QTL detection able to identify causative or LED marker useful for selection. So, using the phenotypes and the genotypes produced in the female nucleus, we estimate the genomic segment effects and then use these to produce genomic breeding values for the selection candidate realms of the herd book. The female informative nucleus is raised in experimental farm in the south of the Sardinia, where they are raised with the typical Sardinian farming system. It consists of around 800 milk ewes with a replacement rate of about 25%. We generate sire families of approximately 9 daughters per ram. All the traits of the economic importance are recorded. Mainly milk yield and composition, functional traits such as milkability and other morphology, health traits, and reproduction traits. The first step of our work was to assess the feasibility of the female nucleus approach by evaluating the ability of the female nucleus to provide accurate GABV of the selection candidate of the herd book. So the first step was to calculate the accuracy of the herd book REMS GABV and to identify a pre-genotyping predictor of the herd book REMS GABV accuracies with two goals. The first, to optimize the size and the structure of the nucleus, and the second, to modulate the flow of animals from the herd book toward the nucleus before genotyping them. The available data were the 3,731 genotype use of the female nucleus along 15 years that correspond to 13,000 milk yield lactation records. We had, moreover, 533 genotyped rams, 144 out of them with daughters in the nucleus, and 389 out of them without daughters in the nucleus. To this available data, we applied a classical traditional GBLAP model, including in the G matrix the use of the nucleus and the 533 rams. For this REM, we were able to estimate the GABV, the GABV, and the accuracy of the GABV. The second step was to identify a pre-genotyping predictor of the accuracy of the herd book REMs. So we realized that the amount of information on relative is the main factor influencing the GABV accuracy. So, for each REM of interest, we built a section of the numerator relationship matrix, including the REM of interest and all the use of the nucleus. So this section of the numerator relationship matrix was inverted, and the diagonal element corresponding to the REM of interest was considered the parameter measuring the information on relatives in the nucleus. Moving to the first results, the accuracy of the GABV for the REMs, for the artificial insemination REMs with daughters in the FIP was quite good, 0.81. The accuracy of GABV of the artificial insemination rams without daughters in FIP in the nucleus was not so good as before, but quite good, the main reason is the relationship, the strong relationship between the artificial insemination rams without daughters and the artificial insemination ram with daughters in the nucleus. The accuracy of GABV for the natural mating rams with no daughters in the nucleus was lower. The other point to underline is the strong relationship existing between the parameter chosen to measure the information on relatives and the accuracies. As you can see, there is a strong tendency of this parameter to increase as the accuracy increases. This is showed also in this slide where we plotted the diagonal element of the inverse of the relationship matrices with the accuracy. And you can see we have a strong relationship between the parameter and the accuracy, and we could easily derive a function predicting the accuracy starting from the diagonal element of the relationship matrix. The second step was to compare the ability of the female informative population to provide the GABV, to provide accurate GABV of the Erdbeek rams respect to a traditional male reference population. To do this, we had to predict the GABV accuracy of Erdbeek selection candidate rams using an Erdbeek male reference population as intercattle, and then compare these accuracies with that expected from the female nucleus. So starting from the 533 genotype rams, we look at the Erdbeek records and we found that 414 rams out of the 533 had daughter with performance in the Erdbeek and then can be used as the male reference population. The further 119 rams had no daughter in the Erdbeek and so can represent the selection candidate Erdbeek population. For the available records were for the 414 rams, more than 39,000 daughters and more than 100,000 milkid lactation records. So to these available data, we applied a classical GBLAP model using as pseudo-phenotypes the daughter yield deviations of the 414 rams with daughters, and including in the G matrix also the 119 rams without daughter. For these rams, we were able to calculate the GABV and its accuracy. Also in this case, we were interested to identify a parameter able to measure the amount of information of relatives in the male reference population and to derive a function for predicting the GABV accuracy. So also in this case, we built a section of the numerator relationship matrix, including the REM of interest and the 414 male reference population REMs. We inverted this section of the numerator relationship matrix, and we extracted the diagonal element corresponding to the REM of interest. Also in this case, we plotted the diagonal element with the calculated accuracies, and we found a good agreement of these two parameters and the possibility to derive a function predicting the accuracy from the diagonal element with a quite good accuracy. Now, We were able, at this moment, we were able to apply the identified predictor of the GABB accuracies to compare the ability of the two reference populations to produce the GABB for the current 310 Earthbook first service RAMs. So the last generation of RAMs able to be used in the Earthbook are 310. And we are interested to compare their estimated breeding value coming from the female informative population of the or from the potential Earthbook reference population. So looking at the pedigree file of these first service RAMs, we rescued 4,189 Earthbook RAMs with daughters with performance records in the Earthbook, which are size and or ancestors of the 310 Earthbook first service RAMs. So this population can be used as a potential reference population to calculate genomic breeding value of the selection candidates. To this comparison, we had to calculate the to predict the GABB accuracies of the selection candidate RAMs from both the female nucleus and the potential male reference population. So, as described before, we built the two numerator relationship matrix corresponding to the two reference population. We inverted them. We extracted the diagonal element. And so we had the parameter to be used to apply the two function to estimate the GABV accuracies of the candidate the selection candidate RAMs. Moving to the results, in this slide, we compare the two reference population, both in terms of information on relatives and in terms of accuracies. Concerning the information on relatives, on average, the information on relatives of the male reference Earthbook population is higher than that on the female nucleus. But in terms of variability, the information on relatives in the Earthbook is much higher than in the female nucleus. Moving into the results in terms of accuracies, the average accuracies of GABV of the candidate, of the selection candidate RAMs was more or less the same. To be precise, the accuracies expected from the female nucleus are slightly higher. We have still a difference in terms of variability. The variability of the accuracies expected from the Earthbook male reference population is higher than that from the female nucleus. So the main results of our work are that the numerator relationship matrix can be used to predict the GABB accuracies of the Earthbook selection candidates, either from a female informative population or a traditional male ancestor informative population. Either the parameter measuring the information on relatives or the predicting function of the accuracies can be improved. The markedly different distribution of the information on relatives and the accuracies between the female and the male ancestors informative population depend on the different count of informative relatives. Male ancestors in the Earthbook reference population, female ancestors, daughters, and half-sisters in the female nucleus. Despite the lower amount of information on relatives, the female informative population produces JBV accuracies of selection candidate and as large as the male informative population. And this is due to the higher heritability of performance records in the nucleus flock. In the Sarda sheep breed, we show that in the Sarda sheep breed, the tenure of size genotyping and daughter's performance recording in the herd book produce on average the same accuracy than the female informative population, but with a much higher variability. Moreover, considering a replacement of 250 ewes per year in the nucleus, the use of 50 rams with 5 daughters per ram will lead to an accuracy of 0.58 for themselves and 0.54 for their sons. As main conclusion, for many traits costly to measure on large scale, the female informative population is a realistic option to produce JBV for the herd book selection candidates' rams. For traits routinely measured in the herd book, such as milk yield, the female informative population is crucial to trigger the application of genomic selection, allowing to produce JBVs since the start of the genotyping program. The progressive pile-up of male genotypes jointly to the application of single-step GBLAP methodologies, combining the female nucleus and herd book data, will allow to get high accuracies of JBV, which could not be obtained using just the female or the male informative population. The causative mutation and LED markers detected in the female nucleus can be used to increase the accuracies of genomic selection. I wish to thank the Research Unit Genetics and Biotechnology of AGRI Sardinia, my colleagues, which collaborate with me to this study. And I wish to thank especially the Italian Sheep Breeders Associations, which collaborate actively to this job. Thank you very much.